Has every right to vote, but when this blind woman tried, she could not because the machine required by law to help her was not ready.
I guess the attitude might be that really they don't care. You know, blind people is a small group of people. So what?
So she just filed a complaint against the Lancaster County Elections Office. Good evening, I'm Brandi Peterson.
I'm Rob McCartney. The I-Team learned the issue not only affects Lancaster County, but other Nebraska counties that get ballots from a third-party vendor.
Tonight, the red tape of running an election and a woman's call for election reform. I-Team investigator Ryan Luby has the story from Lincoln.
Democracy is not only a right. In Nebraska, including in Lancaster County, it's a straight-up convenience anymore.
Oh, for quite a few years.
Just ask Elsie Friesen, one of hundreds of Lincoln voters who vote early.
Because I don't want to stand in line.
Even though Friesen is hard of hearing, she doesn't need any special equipment to fill out her ballot on her own, but not everyone is so fortunate.
Age 18, I had two brain surgeries.
Fatosh Floyd, for instance, lost her sight as a result of those surgeries. This naturalized U.S. citizen, originally from Turkey, needs an automark machine, as it's called.
Please insert your ballot.
To vote secretly without anyone marking a ballot for her. But last week, when Floyd and a blind friend wanted to vote early, they found out the automark at the Lancaster County Election Commissioner's office was never programmed on time the day early voting began on October 1st. The news was upsetting.
That we are not really an important group, that they wouldn't make the effort to make it so that we can vote at the same time.
So Floyd filed a complaint against the commission, saying it violated a portion of the federal Help America Vote Act. The law says voters with disabilities must be allowed to vote in a private and independent manner. In a statement, Lancaster County Election Commissioner Dave Shively says he understands her concerns, but Shively also says in part, I have done everything in my power to have the automark available as quickly as possible for early voting. However, the logistics in making this happen, including very specific ballot certification deadlines outlined in state law, have made it impossible for us to have the automark operational during the first several days of early voting.
Well, this is sure to be an issue that comes up here at the unicameral in Lincoln. In fact, I spoke with State Senator Bill Avery, who is out of town this week, but over the phone he told me that he and his staff are already looking at possible legislative changes to make sure that this problem doesn't happen again.
That's exactly what Adam Moorfeld, founder of Nebraskans for Civic Reform, wants to hear.
Well, what concerns me the most is that it appears as though that this has been an ongoing issue for the last 8 or 9 years.
Moorfeld is now working with Floyd to make sure these machines work.
Please insert your ballot.
And work when they're required to work.
The law is a law. If they say that I have a right to vote at the same time as my peers, starting the same day, then that should be the case.
Ryan Luby, KETV News, Watch 7.
As of this morning, the automark machines in Lancaster County were up and running. Douglas County did not have any problems, and that's because the County Election Commission programs its own automark machines.